As the name k-nearest neighbor suggests, as part of the method, we need to find which points are the nearest neighbors of any given point that we're hoping to classify. Using very informal pseudocode, let's see how we might be able to identify those nearest neighbors. In this case, we have three different steps in our program. The first is to loop over all points. For any given point, we want to compute the distance between point P, the point we're hoping to classify, and every other point. Once we're done with that, we'd like to sort distances and return those k points that are nearest to point P. This informal pseudocode will serve as the starting point for our actual Python code. Before we even start writing any actual code, let's set up a simple test data set so that we can work with it interactively from the start. I'm going to create a vector which is called points. It's a one-dimensional NumPy array, and I'd like to have 9 points in this array. The first point is 1, 1, the second is 1, 2, the third is 1, 3. Then we go with 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, and finally 3, 1, 3, 2, and 3, 3. Because NumPy array expects as input just one list, we need to make sure we embed these rows in another list. We can now run the code, and we have our dataset defined. Let's then also set up a point P, which is a NumPy array consisting of two elements, 2.5 and 2, and we can run the code. Now we have our points and our P defined. Let's then visualize our data to better understand it. We'd like to plot two things, both all of the points and our specific point P of interest. We'll use the PLD plot function. We first need the x coordinates, and then we need the y coordinates. For the x coordinates, we would like to plot all of the rows in column 0, and the y coordinates correspond to all of the rows in column 1. In this case, let's plot these data using red circles. The second thing we'll plot is the point P. In this case, we can use the shorthand notation. P0 corresponds to the first element, P1 the second, and we'll draw this in blue. Let's run both of these lines. In this case, we can see a grid of 9 points, and we can change the axis to make the points more visible. Let's then rerun the plotting, and we can see we have 9 red dots and 1 blue dot. Let's then work with our function. Let's first create an empty array called distances to hold all of our distances. It's going to have the same number of elements as we have rows in our points array. The next step is to loop over all of the points that we have. We're going to be setting up an index I in the range of length of distances. The remaining thing for us to do is to calculate the distance between a point P and each of the points in our array points. Distances I, which is a given element of the array, will be set equal to distance between P and the point which happens to be at the ith location of our points array. So far, we're done with the first two lines of our pseudocode. What are the two nearest points here? There are 2, 2 and 3, 2, and they correspond to columns 4 and 7 in our points array. Let's check this. we can rerun our definition of points, then we can run our code, and we can look at the contents of distances. In this case, if you look at points 4, that's our point 2.2, the corresponding distance, the distance from point P to that point, is 0.5. We can take our point number 7, which is located at 3, 2, and we can check the distance to that point, which is also 0.5. We could sort the distances array to give us sorted distances, but instead what we really would like to get is an index vector that would sort the array. If we had that, we could take the first k elements of that array and know that the corresponding points are the k closest points to our point of interest, p. Fortunately, this function exists in NumPy, and it's called argsort. What it does is it returns the indices that would sort the given array. Let's first explore it interactively. Let's again look at the contents of distances. We'll use the argsort function, apply that to distances, and we will capture the object in int. Let's take a look at that object. It's an array of indices. If we now type distances and we extract the elements at locations given by int, we'll see that the distances have been sorted. If we wanted to take the, say, two nearest elements, we would just pick the first two indices of the int vector. So we would type from 0 to 2, which gives us the elements at locations 0 and 1. And in this case, we have found the two nearest points to our point P. Let's then finish this part and turn it into a function. Going back to our previous code, let's first define the function. We'll call that find nearest neighbors. The input arguments are going to be P, all of the other points, and K, the value of nearest neighbors we're interested in. I'm going to set the default value for that parameter or argument to be equal to 5. In other words, if a user of this function only specifies P and points, Python is going to be using the value 5 for K. We'll make sure to indent the code first. Then we'll use our NumPy argsort, apply to distances. We capture the index as int, and then we'd like to return part of the index vector, the first k elements. In fact, a shorthand notation here would be just to omit the 0, and this does just the same. To wrap up the function, let's add a brief docstring. A description could be find the k nearest neighbors of point P and return their indices. We can then try running our function. Our function has now been defined. Let's then try calling our function. We'll capture the output as int. Find nearest neighbors, P points. I'm going to be using 2 initially. Then I'd like to print the locations of these points. We'll just add a print statement here, print function. And we'll run the line. In this case, Python is returning us the coordinates of the two closest points, the two points that are closest to our fixed point, P. Let's try rerunning this, but we'll change the value of K. Let's try finding the three nearest neighbors. In this case, you'll see that the new point that was added to the set that's returned to us is 2, 1. If you remember our test data set, you can compare these results with the location of the red points and the blue point. Let's then write the function to predict the class of our new point P. We'll call that function knnPredict, and it takes in three parameters, p, the new point we'd like to classify, points, our existing data or our training data, and the value for k. Let's first write this as pseudocode. The first thing we'd like to do is to find k nearest neighbors. And the second step here is for us to predict the class or category of p based on majority vote. We've written the code to accomplish both of these tasks. In this case, we use the findNearestNeighbors function, and the inputs will be p, points, and k. We will capture the output as int, and that takes care of the first step. So far, what we have is the code that enables us to find those points, those k points, that are nearest to p. However, to be able to make a class prediction, we also need to know the classes to which these k points belong to. We'll add one more argument, which is outcomes. And these are the classes of the points that are specified in the input variable points. The one final thing we need to do is to take the majority vote of outcomes based on index, and we'll return this to our user. We can now try running our function, and so far it looks good. Let's try this out. We have previously defined our points. What we need to add is a few outcomes. We had 9 points, therefore we need 9 outcomes. This is going to be defined as a numpy array, and the first 4 entries will be zeros in this example, and the following 5 will be ones. We can run this line, and we can make sure that the length of our outcomes is 9. Let's then try running our knn predict function. The first argument is going to be an array, let's say 2.5, 2.7. Then we need the points, the outcomes, and a value for k. In this case, what knn predict is doing is the following. We are providing a new point that has x coordinate 2.5 and y coordinate 2.7. We're asking Python to classify this point. We have two different classes in this case. We have class 0 and class 1. In this case, what that means is a point, an observation located at 2.5, 2.7 would be predicted to belong to class 1. Let's try predicting the class of another point. Let's say we modify the x-coordinate to 1. So the point is now located at x-coordinate equal to 1.0 and y equal to 2.7. And we can still go with 2 neighbors. We run the code, and in this case the prediction is 0. So we would expect a point located at this position to belong to class 0. Based on this code, we could try out a number of different points and see where the observations are classified as zeros and where they're classified as ones. We'll be doing this, but let's first generate more interesting synthetic data.